Spinal cord stimulation is a technique that we use to treat chronic low back and leg pain in folks that are not surgical candidates but are still dealing with immense pain. What the procedure entails is going through a trial period where we place two percutaneous leads into the patient's epidural space, and the patient then goes home and trials the system for 4 to 5 days. If the patient ends up with a decrease in their pain, an increase in their activity level, and a decrease in their pain medication usage, they are deemed a candidate for the implant. The implant is much like the trial, but involves two very small incisions and the implantation of a battery that will stay in the patient or last for anywhere from 5 to 7 years, depending on the energy requirements that the patient uses for pain relief. To be a candidate for a spinal cord stimulator, the patient will need to fit the criteria of having either low back or radicular leg symptoms. They will also need to get clearance from a neuropsychologist. The neuropsychologist wants to make sure that the patient has undergone other treatment options from a psychological and pain standpoint before moving to this intervention technique, which includes two small incisions. Once the spinal cord stimulator is in place, the patient has multiple options to choose from. Some folks like to be more in control of their spinal cord stimulator settings and can therefore make changes to it as they see fit. Others like to take a more laid-back approach and kind of rely on the settings that are placed to help control their pain. Aside from the general side effects of having two small incisions placed, there is a small risk of bleeding around the spinal cord or having an infection formed in and around the spinal cord. We do our due diligence to make sure that you are off all blood thinners and that you do not have an increased risk for infection prior to proceeding with the implantation. Recovery time for after having a spinal cord stimulator implant is generally anywhere from 1 to 2 weeks of just mild soreness over the incision sites. The hope is that your long-standing severe pain that you had that we are treating is much improved, and we usually see that improvement in the first 2 or 3 days. So overall, even after having a couple small incisions, the patient feels much better shortly thereafter surgery.